Alright. It's the Shroud of the Avatar time again. Release 20 came out today. So there's a whole bunch of new stuff. I've got a list of notes, if I can remember what half of them mean. And I'm going to do my usual thing of basically wandering around and talking about the stuff as it comes up, and you know, once I've got to a reasonable amount of stuff covered, we will go for it, or you know, I'll end a video for that matter. Now, what does this do? Ooh, big eyes. Let's go a little bigger. Not really into spacing, what's the tilt do? Interesting. So this character creation has improved since the last time I tried it, which was a few releases ago. Obviously the reason I'm going through character creation is because everything's been wiped. So everyone's got new characters. And what does that do? Interesting. Nothing really of note. Interesting. I don't think I'm really into nostrils. Alright. That's what that does. Yeah, we'll not have big nostrils. I won't mess around with that too much more. Cheekbone position. Okay. Well, everything seems to be customizable. The mouse cursor doesn't disappear like it did last time. Yeah, it all seems to work fine. Now, I'm not sure how long I'll be stuck with this character, so I've spent a bit of time on it. I think I can live with that. Let's go for it. So yes, everything's been wiped because there's a lot of new crafting stuff in this release. One of the key things is that everything will now take on the colour of its components, sort of thing. Rather than when you build armour, it'll be armour coloured. If you build armour with silver, it'll be silver coloured armour. If you build armour with gold, it'll be gold coloured armour. It's should make for more interesting crafting. Ooh. So we can't really read that. Hello, traveller. There we go. Sword. Yes, I do need a source. A sword. What am I talking about? Press the escape key twice. And go grab the sword. There we go. Now we need to equip the sword. Oh no, we've got the sword. Try out my sword. Attack the practice dummy. Z. Yeah, what's that? Now, the combat has had a lot of changes in this release. Notably, the the fixed versus rotating distinction on the combat bar has basically been removed, in that you now have everyone gets a bar. Let's see, can I get the thing up? Why? Everyone has a bar, and you can lock as many glyphs as you want. So at the minute it starts off with everything locked, but then you can unlock as many as you want. So it's not two different things, it's one thing combined together, essentially. So you can have it either way. The focus skill, so I understand it, the focus skill is gone. Yeah, so you no longer have to invest skills in focus. Everyone just gets the full combat bar. Alright, so carrying on the new player experience, we have to go out the gate, kill some skeletons. Let's do that. Gateway. Oh, new switch. Now I should warn you, I'm currently in the process of downloading 40 gig of Middle-earth Shadow of Mordor. So things might be a little laggy. Ooh, skeleton, right. We're gonna attack the skeleton. There we go. Let's try this gust on him. Am I winning? Yes, I am. Is he going to come back to life? No. Let's take all that money. Victory. Now you can loot these corpses, as I recall. Will you take the chance someone's watching? I see your rifle through the pockets. Let's have a look around. I don't see anyone watching. I'm going to take the money. I don't know how much money I start with. Not much. So I'll do that. Now you see in this release they've changed the highlight indicator. So previously when you're fighting things there was like a red border, and when you were looting things there was a big green border. Now it's a much more subtle effect. You can see that corpse is selected and he sort of glows green, but he's not... It's quite hard to know. You can just see it on his shoulders, look, the glowing of red. Oh, I wiped him out very quickly. So I don't know how much I like that. We'll see. I mean, I'm not that bothered about the realism. I'm more into having a clear indication of what it is I'm fighting. I'm quite into that. Oh. And we're seeing a lot of lag. Again, this probably isn't all the game. I might give up doing the video if it continues to be a problem. But yes, I'm downloading the background. I should probably stop doing that if we're going to demo a game. Odd fellow. Off to the east. So shall we investigate this guy that's off to the east? Exploring the ruins off to the east. Let's have a look over here then. So it's warning us there'll be more undead coming soon. Oh, there's the elf. Let's talk to the elf. here to discover if I'm a creature of destiny. Defenders of Artists, right. So this elf seems to be a method for filling us in on some of the backstory in the lore. I've never checked it out before. Well, there we go. Let's head to the boat and get out of here, shall we? Waste no more time, as I, I'm prone to do, as I investigate this sort of stuff. Right, so there's Edward. And the boat. Oh, we're lagging. The boat is down there. So what I'm going to do is escape on the boat. And while we're doing the area transition, I'm going to pause the download in Steam and try and get some less jerky performance. Ooh. What a load of things going on. Right, anyway. Leave Solace Bridge. And cut. So there we go. I've cut out some stuff going on there. While I was pausing my downloads. There's quite a lot of people standing around the boat. Alright, telling me about combat, which is nice. Head on into Soul Town, find a banker, and get my stuff, because I'm a founder, or backer, or what have you. I do get. Alright, there's the tour guide. Tour guide, sales automaton, skills trainer. There's a bank around here somewhere. Yeah, well, while we're here, it's hard to tell, but the lamp and the signs now move gently in the breeze. In previous releases, they were just fixed objects which stood there. It's a bit hard to tell the difference, but oh, nice outfit, son. It's a bit hard to tell the difference, but on the other hand, someone died. On the other hand, it all adds a bit to the realism, doesn't it? Now, I think that maybe the banker's in here. There. Right. Travelling banker. Yeah, let's load. Right, so this is all the junk I've got because I'm wasting so much money on this game. Well, I say wasting. Spending, that's what I'm doing. I'm spending money in an entirely controlled fashion. So what I want is some armour. So, let's go for that. Don't want to get too encumbered. I want to be able to move around. Chest armor, plate boots. Right, I need some sort of sword, please. Oh, crossbow. Oh yes, I've got a house now. Excellent. Is there a sword? Do I have to use the axe? Founder's cutlass, what's that do? 6 to 18. Crystal sword, 2 to 6. Let's have a cutlass then. Doomsday certificate. Coconuts, love the coconuts. Benefactor's cloak. Alright. And I do have a load of artisan crafting equipment. Where am I at? 64. I think I can afford to carry all this stuff. Cooking pot, cleaver, carpentry hammer. I might as well get that. Just in case we need to be doing any crafting. Loom shuttle, mortar and pestle. Let's do that. Right. So now let's close the bank and equip some armour. Can't equip the plate armor yet because I'm a muppet. Alright, let's put all the plate armor back then. Oh, was I able to click? What have I been able to equip? I don't know, I was able to equip that. Cool. Found the shield. Let's go. Alright, let's go and find the... bank... the shop, I mean. That's what I meant to say. The shop. And selling my junk. Sell from inventory. That all I can sell. Let's do that then. Now, have I got any skill points at this moment? No. So no point in doing any of that. So I think it's now time to head out on the road. Even though it's dark. Did I have a torch? Ah, because I've equipped... Right. Because I've equipped the shield, I have to learn to see in the dark. Right. So. I've been blathering on and dealing with my character. Mostly because I don't want to die as soon as I walk out of the gates. And one of the reasons that might be important is because encounters... which are the sort of random things as you walk along the map, have been improved in this release. So, as we head outside here, we might get something happening as we go along. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run along the coast of Ardoris, which is my fairly normal approach to these first look things. We shall talk about a few things on the way. One thing which won't be immediately obvious is the map now is basically unlimited. The whole of Novia is now implemented. So whereas before there was those invisible walls that we kept walking into, now that shouldn't happen. Now one improvement in this release also is the roads should be easier to see, and I think they're probably right. I'm not sure I like the look of that Right, Cam. Right, so I think I understand. Change in this release is previously everything got a banner like that. East Perennial Trail, South Celestial, who's you what's it. Now only the key plot areas are getting those sort of banners. Yeah, where do I want to go? I have a feeling I want to go that way. It's probably running around in the dark. Yeah, there's Ardoris. So I'm heading towards Ardoris and we're going to go on in. Ooh, I'm getting pulled into a combat. Or actually, it may not be a combat. So there are, I think, 6 scenarios now it's possible to get pulled into. I presume that will extend over time. One of them is a special shop. So I'm not sure what this one is. It doesn't appear to be... Ooh, what's this up here? Doesn't appear to be anything attacking me. Oh! Alright, I'm toast. Run away. Oh! Here I am trying to run away, and I'm in chat! So that was my first encounter. It went badly, it's true to say. Let's go over here and see what that glowing light is. This death animation does look a lot better now. Ooh, there's the Ankh thing. Right, so this is how I can come back to life. So what was that thing over there? Oh, it's daylight now. Was it daylight before? Or was I just not paying attention? So there was something alive over here, wasn't there? I don't know what it was. Anyway. Oh, there's a rabbit. There's a right. Let's see if I can take out a skeleton. Let's just check what my... I don't seem to take any damage. What are these things? Right, I'm gaining double experience and double whatchamacallit. Because I previously played the game. So I can see some cotton up there. So what I want is to just like launch a single skeleton into... No. Ugh. No. Toast. They all got up together. That was an improvement in the last release, actually. In that... why does it keep doing that? WWW. That was an improvement in the last release that... the enemies talk to each other more, or they make each other aware, so it's much more difficult to just kill one of them while the other one stand there and watch you do it, because they cry out for help and stuff. So, as I was saying before, I got killed by skeletons. Oh, it's night outside again. Well, there you go. Before I got killed by skeletons, there are, I think, 6 different encounters, one of which is a rare goods merchant. There's a skeletons one, which is one we've just seen there. There's a beset by a pack of wolves one. I can't remember off the top of my head the other ones, but clearly the skeleton one is much more of a challenge than all the ones I've done before, where it was, you know, it was just kind of boring killing stuff. So as we head into Ardoris, I want to go and have a look around in Ardoris and speak to some of the NPCs, because apparently the NPC dialogue in Ardoris has now been entirely crowdsourced. I'm not quite sure what the mechanism was for how this would work, but instead of all just being placeholder text, actual people have contributed what it is the NPCs are going to say. So dark here again. So let's see what there is around. Address Bateman. Christian surname. That's an interesting name, sir. Hello, Christian surname. Yeah. Where's my chat window gone now? Hello, Address Bateman. Oh. Well, that's easier than running around, I suppose. I'm not really that bothered, though. Because part of the point here is to run around. Let's see if the guards will speak to me. Hello, Outlander. Let's just ask him his name. Abe. He looks strangely dark, doesn't he? Alright, so he's got a mask on. Abe the guard. Let's see what this bloke's called. Hello. What is your name? Finn the guard. What is the Isle of Eternal Dawn? Ah, very nice. Right, let's stop chatting to them. Let's head on into town and see what's going on. I want to try and pin that, but not have it come where I meet or don't. I want to have the chat window pinned and then not spend a lot of time typing W into it repeatedly. Oh, can I speak to the town crier? Hello. Ah. Deliver the mail. Oh, so we can go back to Slania and give a package, and that is something I want to do, because there is some new stuff involved there. Set compass destination. Right. I want to get out of the chat now, thank you. Okay, escape didn't work. So I can now head towards wherever this house is. And I think now that I've spent sufficient amount of money on the game, I can just claim it straight away. Which I've never done before. I don't know where it'll be though. Have I got a map of Ardoris? No, I've got a map of Solis Bridge. They're in the square. I think I can't go that way. So let's toddle off over here. So I don't know if that's the crowdsourced. It's hard to tell really, isn't it? I mean, it's just dialogue. Just dialogue, right. Let's see if I can find this house. Assuming if I walk past it, the compass direction will rapidly change. Yeah, there's a bridge. Row lot. Deeds. Alright, because it's still in the bank. Right. So, if I'd been paying attention, I would have realised that was a waste of time. But never mind. Let's head back to the crafting station and talk about some crafting some more. Now, while I'm wandering back and trying not to get lost, one of the big things that's been introduced in this release is creature taming. So now it's possible to tame some creatures if you have, I think, a taming collar. I think that's what you need. Oh, there's a market. I want to get back there. Now, the only way to get a taming collar is to craft it, or to buy one off someone who's crafted it. So this is indicating what they've always wanted the game to be, in that a lot of the items, you know, that the crafting is a player driven economy. Oh, I can't get through that gap. Get a fresh fish, he says. Yeah, so part of this, the crafting, the player driven economy, is that important stuff, fundamental stuff to actually, you know, playing the game, is only available if players craft it. It's not something that's just going to be sitting at vendors waiting for things. So let's see if anyone's crafted anything yet. No. Oh, some wooden storage chests. Semi-Hein has been crafting things. Another guard over there. Various crafting equipment, but then I've not got any money at the minute, so doesn't really matter. I can't buy any of the crafting stuff. Let's just head over. Let's pick one of these at random. What's this one? Milling table. Right. Oh, there we go. I thought it had all gone wrong. So, I can't build any of this stuff. But here's the crafting recipes. I've not got any of the ingredients for anything at the minute. I do have a carpentry hammer, so I can start making chairs at some point in the near future. And deer carcass, right. So the crafting has been improved, obviously, because I'm just starting out. Can't do anything with the crafting at the minute. I may come back later, because I don't think the grand quest this time isn't a strenuous one. So it's like the last grand quest, in that it's basically a fetching things quest rather than a run round all the map looking at all the new things type of quest. Now, there is a lot of new things on the map. As I said, the Novia Overland is now complete, and there's also something ridiculous like 100 odd player towns now in this release. I've no idea where they all are. At some point it might be worth, I'm sure someone will do it actually, they'll do a video of visiting all the player towns. I think that'll be a nice little road trip. Visit every single player town. I'm going to head back to Sultan now and deliver that package, because one of the last things I want to talk about is a new quest completion UI. So before it wasn't really that obvious when you were on a quest and when you're completing a quest. Probably still isn't that obvious. It goes in your journal. But apparently there is a new UI for completing them. Alright, so I've been given a packet of mail to deliver to the town crier in Slania. So that's what I'm going to do. On the way back, if we don't get dragged into a random counter, should be... There's Christian's surname again. It should be... Sorry, totally lost the thread there. Right, it should be noted that there is a huge new feature in this release, and that's large creatures to battle. I think they are trolls. Where's this? That's not Sultan, is it? No. Oh, it was Sultan. I totally missed the sign. There we go. Sultan. Let's enter. Since I've not leveled up at all, there's really no point in me going to try and find one of these large creatures. There's also some new stuff to do with the control points, Virtus Pass and all that sort of thing. Siege weapons, apparently. I'm quite interested to go and look at them in a short while. Not on this video, though. I'll be wrapping this up quite soon. And I think I've talked about virtually everything I want to talk about. Oh, books. Books are finally in that. You can write in books and then have books printed and stuff like that, which could be quite interesting. You can write in the books in runes, that, you know, the runes you see on the banners. So if you're proficient in reading those runes, then I guess good for you. So let's try delivering this. There's a town crier. Hello. Alright. Package. Okay, I don't understand. There's my journal. Packet. Oh, not package. Mail. Let's try mail. Yes. Oh, what a high little block there. Oh, Salaya. Here I am in Soul Town. Right, so I'm an idiot. Let's see if we can find Salaya. And then wrap up the video. Carl's Armour Pudding. You can't read, let alone runes. It's definitely looking nice with the, I think speed trees is the technology. The trees all look a bit varied and you know, reasonably realistic. Looks quite nice, doesn't it? So where is Salaya, we ask ourselves. Let's make the video unnecessarily long. You watch me wander fruitlessly around the map. So if I don't find it quickly, I'll be cutting back to this point. Okay, so because I'm a Muppet who can't tell the difference between Soul Town and Selenia, I've been to the wrong place trying to give the package back. So now, having spent many minutes running around fruitlessly trying to locate the right town, I've now more or less figured it out. So I'm going to cut a big chunk out of the video and head in the right general direction. So what I think is, we got the foothills. No. We go around the foothills. Up this way. What we want to do is go, there we go, through the swamp. Slania, there was a tour guide there once. What it may be worth me doing is equipping a torch instead of a shield. Let's see if I've got one. Let's do that. There we go. So what we're trying to do is get across the river. No. There's the bridge. There we go. You follow this winding trail. There's a lot of people on the trail, which indicates we've all had the same quest. North Celestial Wetlands. There's Slania, over there. You see the roads actually are easy to see in this release. Let's enter Slania. Any second now, enter Slania. Any second now. And we can find the town crier and complete the quest. And hopefully see this new quest completion AI. Maybe Slania is massively busy at the moment. There we go, because everybody's trying to deliver mail there. But we're in. Right. Guard. Hello, guard. Ooh. There's a nice glowing thing over there. What does that indicate? It's some sort of flag. Very nice. Who are you? There's a vendor. A vendor next to a glowing flag, right. We need to find the town crier. Oh, there's a skills trainer. There he is. Hello. I received 75 gold. Mail package for Ardoris. So, let's it turns out there wasn't really any new UI for quest completion, unless that wasn't it. A bit of a disappointment in the end. But obviously I see a good approach for starter gold is this mail delivery stuff. So I'll wrap up the video there. I should probably carry on for a little bit longer and see if I can sort out my house. I'll keep it recording, and if anything interesting happens, I will. Oh, there's a moon. If anything interesting happens, I can then upload it right at the end of the video. So there you go. Shroud of the Avatar release 20 out today. Investigate now if you're interested. Okay, I'm back in Ardoris. I've been to Slania, picked up some more mail, I'm back to Soul Town and I've picked up my my row lot and my row house from the banker. So I'm going to go and find the town crier again and give him some mail and then go and get myself a house. There he is. Hello. Excellent. 75 gold. So, I'm not really sure where all of these might be. Let's set destination and see what happens. So let me just grab my inventory here. So, stone two-story row home, rent-free found a lot deed. So, I should be able to walk up to the house and claim it. Although I don't know if I want to go wherever that one is. Let's go over this way. Seems to be right. Now, of course, one way of doing this is you wander around, you find the house you want, and then you claim it. You don't need to pick from the town crier. Okay, so was that it there? Arrived at destination lot. Oh. So he's claimed it already. Well, this one. So, was it just lying about? About it being available? Come on. So these are all claimed. Which is a bit mysterious. So, if they're all claimed, let's head back towards that one I was at before and see if I can claim that one now. Through the market, over the bridge. What's this one? That's claimed. Someone's got all the houses. Claimed in the last hour. Look, if only I'd remember to bring my. Ooh. Right, so I can claim this one. Claim current lot. Yes. Okay. So next question is, how do I get up there? Not that way, apparently. I can unclaim. Interesting. So, if I like this one better, what's this? Alright, so let's unclaim that lot. Unclaim. Okay. No need to pack. Deeds. Claim current lot. So, I have a house. Select. Accept. Yes. So, I have a house. Now what I don't know is how the house works. Something I'll find out for next time. I can put the fire out, I can put the fire on. Excellent. Close, no, it's the, probably that that I want. No, I don't know. Zone to lot. So I have myself a house. There's nothing in it. But it's mine. Let's go and check out the view. There we go. I can see the canal, or is it the river? And the houses across the street. So, there we go. An appropriate place for me to finish the video altogether. I'll have to do some editing to get that down. I'm at an hour and a half of recording time now. No point trying to upload that. That was Shroud the Avatar R20, some of the new features of. There is a grand tour. I'll be uploading a video of that over the weekend. And possibly, if I can level up a bit, we shall try some crafting and creature taming later on. Well, there you go. Shroud the Avatar R20 released today.